fun. So the other day I was having a discussion with one of my close friends. We're basically discussing about our favorite stores for buying particular items, and that's pretty much what inspired this video. One of the reasons why a lot of us shop at Zara, one of the reasons why we love their stuff, is because they are very, very good at replicating designer pieces but putting your own spin on it. It's not to say they don't come up with their own stuff, because they absolutely do, but a lot of times they would go for what they think is going to be in style, and that's usually set by a lot of the designer houses. So I've been shopping at Zara for, I want to say, 15 years now, give or take a couple of years, and I think I've mastered the items from Zara that I want to say are great value for money, because obviously my wardrobe is arguably 80% items from Zara. Now that's shifting because I haven't been shopping at Zara the way I used to. And so over the years, I've got a very good understanding of what is value for money and what is just a waste of money. And so if I'm spending my money buying something that I think is not so great, at least I know it's not so great, and I've just decided I want to get that particular item. So I thought it would be great to put a video together for you guys to let you know, obviously from my experience, what I think is the top 5 items that are great value for money. And I'll most likely do another one that says pretty much don't buy this stuff from Zara because you're literally throwing away your money. So yeah, to my returning viewers and subscribers, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being there and continuously watching my video. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Odette and I do fashion and lifestyle videos for the working girl. So we discuss everything from regular high street stores such as Zara all the way to luxury items. And today we are discussing, obviously, high street store stuff because we're talking about Zara. So as I'm talking through some of the items, I will show them to you, at least the ones that I have. If I don't have it with me right now, maybe because it's in the wash or I just can't find it, then I would probably show you something similar on the actual Zara website. If there's one thing that I would always encourage any and everyone to get from Zara, because they do it so well and you can get it at great prices, is a blazer. Like, Zara blazers are just incredibly made. So when I'm talking about Zara blazers, I mean the more expensive ones, the ones that they typically price from maybe £59.99 to from £60, possibly all the way to £90 originally. So originally that's their price, but I would not advise you to buy it at that price. More likely it would go to sale at some point. So I would say save it in your basket, and during the summer sales or the winter sales, you can pick it up. Well, that's pretty much how I've shopped at Zara, well, always, for as long as I can remember. A good example of one of their items that they do so well, like I mentioned, is a blazer. And this one is very reminiscent of the Balmain style blazer, because you have both buttons here, the military style blazer, which is, again, Balmain. This, each time I wear this blazer, whether that's to work out, I get so many compliments on this. Obviously, this is not Balmain, this is Zara. And I picked this up on sale for £39.99, so that's £40. I picked it up about 4 years ago. And till this day, this blazer still stands tall, no issues whatsoever, very comfortable. It is arguably one of my best blazers. One of the things I love about this as well is that if you put up the color, you get this dark woolish fabric or material or color that you get there. So yeah, so this is a prime example of a very well made blazer. And this blazer, I believe at the time I was buying it, was originally maybe £60. Maybe now if you go to look at it, I'm not sure what it is now. I would put a link to something similar on their website so that you can have a look. Another item that I picked up during the sale, and this one might have been, I think this one was £29.99 when I picked it up. This is a tweed blazer with black trim going around it. Again, beautifully made. I don't know what this is meant to be reminiscent of. Maybe it's still meant to be Balmain. I don't really get that feeling. With this one, I definitely got the Balmain thing. I think they nailed it quite well. But this one, not really, because again, when you think of tweed, you think of Chanel. So maybe that's what this is trying to mimic, Chanel. Now, this is a tweed blazer, and I typically don't know how long lasting their tweeds are, because this is the first one that I've got and I've never actually worn it out. It's been in my wardrobe because I've just never found a place to wear it to. I have so many blazers from Zara and I typically wear those ones. This is a beautifully made blazer. The quality feels very well. So again, two great blazers that I didn't have to pay full price for. If this was supposed to be full price, it would have been, both of them would have been 140, but I paid about £80 combined, give or take, 70 to £80 give or take. So that's almost half the price if you combine them together. I wouldn't go for their blazers that are originally $29.99. I mean they're okay, but they're not what I'm talking about when I said Zara blazers. When I'm saying Zara blazers, I'm referring to the ones that are £60, originally £60 and above. But like I mentioned, you can get them on sale for as low as $29.99 depending on whether your size is still available. The next item I think Zara does extremely well are statement earrings. So this is a very good example of that. I think they do amazing statement earrings. I have a second pair, and I think this one was a very popular one because a lot of people, when they came out, have them. Zara's statement earrings get sold out all the time, especially the ones that, you know, make their rounds around social media. If you see one that everyone's raving about, it will be almost impossible to find it in the store. But that's the thing, they do really good statement pieces for a good price. And the thing about statement pieces is that you don't have to wear them all the time. As a matter of fact, you shouldn't wear them all the time because they're not daily pieces. They're stuff that you wear when you want to make a statement or for a special occasion. And so what you find is that they're actually long-lasting as well because you don't wear them all the time. Unless you're constantly going to parties, I don't know. But if you're not constantly going to parties, then chances are you're not going to wear it all the time. I think that these are extremely gorgeous, as well as these two. I just love wearing them. Their statement pieces typically go from anywhere from £9.99 to about maybe £29 or £30. So the next item that I think is great value for money from Zara is this blouse. This blouse, I picked it up in the medium, and I picked it up many years ago. This was originally going for £70, but I paid £29.99 for this, if I'm not mistaken, because it went on sale. So this is actually a silk blend, and the quality, the feel of the material is amazing. The cut is amazing on the body as well. What I also love about this is that the buttons are made of this aged gold hardware, and they're not your standard buttons. They're actually different crests, and I thought that was an interesting take on the buttons. But I absolutely love this. I normally take this to the dry cleaners to get clean because I don't want anything to happen to it. When I compare this to some of the stuff that I buy from the likes of Karen Millen that actually do very good quality silk shirts as well, I think they can be on the same line. So even though I picked this up from the sale, I could have purchased this full price and not regretted it at all, just because of the quality of this. So the fourth item that I believe Zara does so well are their shoes. And again, it's not every shoe from them that I would recommend that you get. Definitely go for the higher end ones. And I want to show you two examples here of some of my favorite heels. So this is the first one. I picked this one up from Zara maybe in 2019, I believe. Picked it up from the sales. I picked it up for £19.99. This were originally going for £60 at the time. But obviously they went in the sale, and I was so lucky with this one because I was looking for it everywhere. And I one day walked into a Zara in, I think it's the one in Bond Street, and I just saw it standing there. So, oh no, Regent Street, sorry. And I just saw it standing there. This is such a pretty shoe. Whenever I wear it at work, people are always complimenting me on it. What I really love about this is that, yes, it's from the front, it just looks like a simple red shoes with a blue on the tip. But when you look at it at the back, you have this ruffles and this blue that peaks in here. So they're very good at doing stylish shoes and good quality shoes. Again, I would not rate their shoes that are originally $29.99. I bought heels from Zara that were originally $29.99. They don't fit great on my feet. They just look very weird. But with something like this, the make of it is amazing, and I don't have that same problem. Another pair of heels that are within that category as well. I love these so much. It's like this faux snake print that it has on it, but I thought it was really cute. And obviously it has the ankle wrap around with the straps that you have. So again, this one I actually paid full price for, by the way. I picked it up at the airport, and it's one of my favorite heels. Whenever I'm wearing a hint of green or yellow, I find myself always reaching for these ones. And whenever I wear it, I get compliments of work. And most recently I purchased this green pair of heels from Zara almost as a replacement for my Bottega Veneta ones. So I obviously love my Bottega Veneta ones, but I can't actually wear it to work. But I wear this one to work because it's just an open toe heel. Very comfortable, I have to say, and so are the other two. Extremely comfortable to walk in. I've never had any issues with it. I wear it to work, and I'm literally wearing them for the entire day. They might still be there on Zara. If they are, I'll put a link. But I believe they were almost £50, if I'm not mistaken. I feel like they were £50, give or take. Next item that I think that is great value for money are the Zara basics. And when I say basics, I don't mean every single thing that they have. I just mean their basic tops, and I'll show you an example of what I mean. They remind me obviously very much of the Skims, Kim Kardashian Skims. Actually, I think it's the other way around. Zara used to do this before Kim Kardashian started doing her Skims, because I do have, I think, two or three tops that are like, in fact, exactly this one from them. And they do them so well. This is one of my most worn tops. I wear them all the time for everything. They're extremely comfortable. They're lightweight. You don't feel like you're wearing something. So I wash them in the machine, never lose their shape, never had any bubbles, never had any issues with them. They're just nice, simple to wear. When it comes to these two tops, Zara for me has just nailed it. I've had mine for about 4 or 5 years now. Personally, my favorite place to buy jeans from is Hollister. I have not seen anyone who makes better fitted jeans than Hollister. If I'm not buying from them, I'm buying from Zara, because again, jeans are very affordable, typically between $29.99 to $39.99. That's usually their price range. Comfortable and very trendy as well. So if you have boyfriend jeans that are trendy, they would have a couple straight leg jeans, all sorts of jeans Zara does. And like I said, they do it quite well, and you're not essentially breaking the bank for their pair of jeans. So that's something that I think, again, if you're contemplating getting jeans from Zara, I would definitely say go ahead and get it. You're not gonna have any issues with them. The final item that I think Zara does well, and I think this is really where you can see the ability to mimic designer pieces. Obviously, they're not trying to copy and paste what designer are doing, but they're trying to put their own twists on trendy pieces. And that is in bags. I think Zara does a great job at their bags. Like most of the items, they have the really good quality bags, and the bags that are not particularly great quality, but they look amazing. So these are basket bags. I bought these bags in 2018, so that's almost 4 years now. And I've not had any issues with them. Granted, I don't wear them all the time. I usually just pull them out either when I'm going somewhere on vacation, like to a warm country, or in the UK like now, because they're basket bags and they just go well with maxi dresses, that kind of spring summer vibes. If you open this, so this like this, and it's the size semi-moon shape as well, which is a very popular shape. A lot of designers tend to have this type of shape. Mind you, I bought this in 2018, and like I said, it still stands. It's white, you don't see any discoloration on it. I say all that to say that they have really good designer bags. I remember when the boy bag came out, Zara did their version of what looked like a boy bag, and that was going for almost £100, and I remember a lot of people went crazy for that bag. I waited in vain for that bag to go on sale, and obviously never did, because it was one of their best-selling items. It's a way of getting close to a designer item, but not really. And theirs were real leather as well. So Zara is again very good on putting your own spin on designer pieces. Not every bag in Zara is amazing. You kind of have to pick and choose, but a lot of them are really good quality, especially when you start going beyond the £30, £40 mark. You begin to see where the quality in Zara really lies. Those are the top 7 things that I'll definitely recommend you buying from Zara, value for money. If you have shopped in Zara previously, do let me know in the comment section which items you found to be great value for money. Let's have a chat. If you've watched to this point, that means you've enjoyed the video, so go ahead and give us a thumbs up for this video. It helps with the algorithm and it helps YouTube push it out so that other people can watch the video as well. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, I'm not sure why that is. You have to subscribe. Go ahead and subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you know every single time I upload. Also, I want to say definitely follow me on Instagram, because I do a lot of styling videos on there, and TikTok as well. Go ahead and show me love on there. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye bye.